for hundreds of years, and they decided, of all times, why not do it when the British are occupying with someone? It's just kind of making it black and white, but essentially they gathered up a few hundred people, staged a resistance, and initially they were quite successful. They holed up in the post office in Dublin, and the British were kind of not laying a finger on them until the following couple of days, Easter week, when they sent in 12,000 troops as reinforcements, brutally crushed them, and what was left looked like the end of an Irish fight for independence. As it turns out, entangling alliances being what they are now, in World War I, there was a lot of political pressure put on Britain to kind of leave this problem behind, and they did. And that was kind of the germination of the Irish independence. What we've got here, that's kind of the short story. what we've got here is a ballad, basically, that tells the story of a person who's going down witnessing this entire uprising taking place. First the uprising, and then the brutal crush that comes afterwards. Easter Rebellion.
We wanted to introduce, too, this guy. He's dressed this way because he can't rap in a robe, I guess. Rap in dress clothes. What's your name?
Brian.
What's your rap
name? No! D-Boy?
D-Boy, stand for Doughboy, I guess, is what he says.
Oh.